on the increasing of crime rate among school children. Alright, now, let us think of this situation. You are happy that a child is going to school and studying well. But one day, he came back home, crying, bruises all over his body. And so, of course, you're asking, what happened to you, son? And then he replied, I've got beaten at school. This painful and dreadful act is called school violence, and it is creating a lot of troubles among school pupils. But we're glad to be here today to share, at the same time, gain knowledge on what are the factors that will increase the crime rate among school children and how can we reduce it from happening. First of all, please allow me to introduce our panel for today's forum. On my right, first speaker, Ms. Hazel, who is the president of the English Language Society.
I'm glad to be here.
On my left, our second speaker, Mr. Lee, who is the president of the Chinese Language Society. It's an honor to be here. Just beside him is our third speaker, Ms. Michelle, who is the president of the school debate team.
I'm excited for the sharing.
They will be sharing their opinions on these matters and what actually causes the crime rate to increase. Alright, so shall we start with Ms. Hazel? Ms. Hazel, in your opinion, what are the factors that will increase the crime rate among school children?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Well, there are many reasons that might become the factors that increase the crime rate among school children. The main reason of the increasing crime rate among school children is due to the lack of parental guidance to the children. Because of the increasing inflation rate and deteriorating economy, parents have become increasingly busy with their job and they don't spend enough time with their children. They don't have time to talk to them, listen to them, know their problems, and simply, they don't know their children enough. As a result, children don't get enough attention they need and deserve. Even if the kids have to deal with negative consequences afterwards, they turn into antisocial behavior in hope after being notified by the teachers, it will eventually alarm the parents and remind them of their existence. Therefore, the lack of proper parental guidance is a main contributory factor for children's disciplinary behavior.
Well said. But you say so. There are some housewives taking care of their child himself. Yet, a lot of the children don't really talk to them. Why is that so?
I'm glad that you asked. The communication gap between parents and their children may be due to many parents being young and ill-prepared for parenting. Therefore, they fail to connect with their children. And that is the reason why they cannot solve their children's problem. On most occasions, students with rude behavior come from little supervision backgrounds where they receive at home. Many parents didn't recognize that most students misbehave to get attention. This communication gap has allowed the children to venture into various types of negative behaviors.
Alright, thank you very much, Ms. Hazel. Now, what about you, Mr. Lee?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I agree with the opinion that the increasing crime rate among school children could be due to lack of parental guidance. However, in my opinion, the main factor is due to stress that school children are facing nowadays. Well, guys, as we can see, school children are facing much heavier stress than we did in the past. We used to play and have fun at school, but having piles and piles of homeworks, exams, the students' burden increased tremendously. They are all covered by teachers' criticism
very important.